County Council President Tom Hucker announced this week that he's planning to run for the county executive seat in 2022. Hucker joins an already crowded field, including the sitting county executive, Mark Elrich, who's seeking re-election, as well as council members Hans Reimer and businessman David Blair. We're exceedingly fortunate today to have former council member Nancy Floreen with us today to help us analyze this race. Welcome to 21 This Week, Nancy.
Thanks for having me.
We're looking forward to your insight on this. Yeah. Nancy, I asked my late father-in-law, who served in Congress for 36 years, why he entered politics, and his response was he thought he could do a better job than the other guy. So with all of these candidates running for county executives, is it that simple? Do they just think they can do a better job than Mark Elrich? And if so, what's Mark doing wrong?
Well, I think that's certainly the case. Tom is suffering from the disease that affects all people who act as council president, because you become the speaker for the county in many ways, and you are reminded that you're terrific at it. And so, Tom is, with the redistricting going on as well, it looks to me like Tom's in that wacky district that includes Tacoma Park, Garrett Park in Kensington. And if that's the case, he's going to have a run for his seat no matter what, because that's a new district for him. So he's looking for a job. Hans needs a job. And David Blair, you know, he's out there trying to make things better himself. So, it's ego, ego, ego. It's sort of a repeat of 2018. And council members, get frustrated dealing with the county executive on various levels, and they always feel that they could do a better job. There's no question about that.
So when we look at the race, and you've mentioned all three candidates, in their announcements, Hucker and Hans Reimer paid lip service to improving the business climate in the county. But it really seems when you analyze it that Elrich, Hucker, and Reimer will be trying to out-progressive one another, just as they have, for the last 2 years.
Well, the good news is they can carpool to all the various events, because they all live about a mile from each other. And basically, they're all from Tacoma Park. All the politicians these days are from Tacoma Park. And so it's just what it is. It's typical. The business issue, I don't think is a winner particularly. It hasn't won elections for other people in the past. Most of the business people actually are Republicans. They don't vote in the Democratic primary anyways, no matter what I tell them to switch parties and then switch back. So they don't. So consequently, the business community really has never had an active role in any of this. They make contributions, but they don't vote. And that's kind of a challenge.
So I don't think
it's a selling issue.
Well, Cary, that Nissan Leaf that Mark owns is going to be pretty tight if they try to carpool. So in the 2018 election, as Nancy talked about, we saw a very divided field, but it was Mark's base that was able to be sufficiently large to let him win. Are we going to see a repeat in 2022?
It's difficult to say at this point. You've got Hans Reimer, to Hucker, Mark Elrich, all Tacoma Park, Silver Spring. And then you've got David Blair sitting on the wings, not saying a word about the issues. He's a businessman. It's an entirely different election. You got to look at the council in the past 4 years. All of them have been running for election. That's been seen in Viva White Oak and that contentious, Mark's not supportive of it. He voted against it. Yeah, but he's got $40 million waiting to put into it. We need jobs. Get the jobs. You've got the Beltway debacle and what's going to happen there. And the council has to step in and become county executive and negotiate with the governor. It's been 4 years of not knowing who's running the county. That's the problem. They need to walk across the street, sit down, develop a strategic plan, and get to business. But they haven't seemed to do that. That's my opinion.
So, Phil, I polled our fellow panelist on 21 This Week, panelist Mark Unkefer, and asked him, whether or not there was going to be a candidate running for county executive. And he said there's still no one that has mentioned that they're going to be stepping up. So what are Republicans going to do? You heard Nancy's proposal, which is all Republicans should at least change their party affiliations for the primary. Is that what Republicans are going to do?
No, I don't think that's a great idea. You know, the first thing, and this is what, and we talked a little bit about off air, is, you know, growing the grassroots. Now, the Montgomery County Republican Party has a very, very strong party organization itself. But one of the things that happens when you've lost for a long time is you lose a lot of the grassroots, the people who will may not agree with you on 100% of the issues, but they agree with you enough that they'd cast a ballot for you. It's to go around and make sure that those people know that you're there, know that you want to be, that you need them on their team. And then number two, to get them active. So that's step one. And step two, I do believe there's going to be a Republican candidate, because one of the things that we saw from what happened in Virginia and New Jersey is that when you challenge Democrats, even in difficult areas, there are going to be people who will go out, even if they don't necessarily share your party registration, but they'll listen to what both sides have to say, and they may very well vote for you. So when you put that combination together, and add in what we've all been talking about here with the business community, well, the business community itself, you know, rarely is in a position to swing elections, except maybe in the state of Georgia. You know, we are now more than ever attuned to the impact that government can have on business and that business has on us. So you will see, I think, more and more interest in what's going on there. So that actually does portend to better Republican showing in this race and in the future.
Well, we'll have to wait and see whether there's a breakthrough and a crossover of support based on the same issues that we saw in Virginia. Up till now, those education issues have not been in the forefront of voters' minds. Even in the last school board election race, they were not. They were kind of muted when with some candidates talking about critical race theory. It never really came out as a strong issue that people were opposed to. So Nancy, right now, who do you think has the advantage? More than a year, we're even a year, you know, we're not even, you know, we got time before the filing deadline.
Right. Look, Mark has it to lose. The real issue is, will people run a negative campaign against him? That's not well received in this county. I've been involved in some of those things. So are people going to point out Mark's flaws? And are they flaws that speak to the electorate? I think that's going to be the big challenge for anyone challenging an incumbent. You know, Hans and Tom and Mark are pretty indistinguishable, except Mark is farther to the left, I think, than the two of them. But how do you convey that?
Yeah. We'll see. Well, Cary, I'm going to let you have the last word, because, you know, there are those who feel that they're going to focus mostly on the response to COVID and that Mark has done a pretty good job on that.
He may have, but I still believe that Thrive and the Attainable Housing Initiative is going to carry the day. And if a Republican actually catches on to that, you know, we might see a Connie Morella type of county executive. I mean, that's where we're heading to.